Hello, everyone. Today, we will have an exciting tutorial for you where we'll be showing you step-by-step how to install the open source Neo4j graph database on Kubernetes. We'll use the official Helm chart, Google Kubernetes Engine as our environment of choice, and Google Cloud's networking services like Cloud DNS. That said, the demonstrated steps are relatively portable to other Kubernetes environments and DNS providers. When we run the Helm installation, we'll get a Google Cloud load balancer for our ingress resources in Kubernetes. These will be managed by Kubernetes, but can also be viewed and understood outside of it in the Google Cloud console. We'll use HTTPS load balancers with Certificate Manager and Google Managed Certificates. Not only will we demonstrate this installation, but we'll also show you how to connect using the Bolt protocol and the WebSockets approach. We'll even take a quick look at the Neo4j browser for structuring, running, and visualizing graph queries. All code is available in the GitHub repository that's linked in the description of this video. All right, let's jump into the Google Cloud console and set up our resources. We'll be using Google Cloud Shell to run the required terminal commands and to set up the resources for our Neo4j setup. I've already set up a Google Kubernetes Engine cluster with three nodes and the container-optimized operating system. You might want to increase the number of nodes or resources in your cluster, as the default Neo4j installation has non-negligible CPU and memory requirements. Now, let's create our chart.yaml file and add a dependency on the official Neo4j Helm chart. We'll be using version 5.6.0 in this demonstration. Next, we need a values file where we'll specify a name for the Neo4j instance and a password for the username. We recommend providing a password or password secret explicitly, as the automatic password generation and management can be a bit unintuitive. We can adjust the resources for our Neo4j installation, such as CPU and memory. We also have a backend config for our Neo4j service so that we can serve our secure WebSocket Bolt connection over HTTPS networking without health checking issues. We'll disable the TLS level and instead use SSL termination at the load balancer. This setup works, but in a steady state production configuration, you'll likely need to tune the ingress approach, such as with timeouts, connection draining, and session affinity, or just use the service on internal cluster IP Kubernetes networking. While TCP WebSocket connections are generally compatible with HTTP ingress networking, you may want to better optimize the networking for your own context. Next, we'll create our networking.yaml file and add some additional configurations for networking on top of the Helm provisioned resources. This includes Google Managed Certificates, front-end configurations, and ingress resources for domain-based routing. We'll route the browser domain to the HTTP port on the Neo4j service and route the Bolt domain to the Bolt port on the Neo4j service. Note that the Helm chart has some configuration around load balancers and exposing your Neo4j instance publicly, but unfortunately that configuration is scoped to the enterprise rather than community version. Instead of forking and modifying this Helm chart, we're building the additional required networking on top of it with this networking.yaml file. So once we've updated our dependencies and set up the networking, We'll reserve an external static IP in the Cloud Console. And create DNS records for our bolts and browser connections. With all the networking in place, we can finally run the Helm installation. The provisioning of the managed certificate for SSL might take some time. But once it's active, we can go to our Neo4j browser and point it to our instance. We'll change the connection details to use the Bolt protocol, port 443, and our Bolt domain. We'll use the Neo4j username and the password that we set earlier. Now that we've connected, we can play with some live data, like a graph of movies, actors, and directors. If you want a Helm repository to cleanly package up your Neo4j Helm code for reuse and sharing, check our simple serverless Helm repository demonstration video, which is linked in the description of this video. And that's it, folks. We hope this tutorial was helpful, and we'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions. Thanks for watching.